most of us see trees in winter with their fallen leaves and we don't see the beauty. But that is not the case for acclaimed artist Charles Brindley. He sees the beauty in trees all season long. His work is the featured work here at Cheekwood, and we would love for you to meet him. This is Charles Brindley. Hi.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for allowing us to come out and share in
well,
the
beauty. Well, it's a delight for me and for Cheekwood.
Well, wonderful. So, Charles, when you see a tree, be it wintertime, no leaves on it whatsoever, what do you see?
Well, I think what we see in this exhibit is a whole broad selection of trees, both in summer and winter. But something that's getting a lot of attention here with the exhibit is the structure of the tree and what I call the branchology. So there are a number of paintings that have been selected for this exhibit that I've done that show trees in winter with the branchology. And so often it's the structure that's so dynamic that we see during the winter versus summer, because often with some trees like maples and oaks, they just become a big green blur.
They really do.
In the summer. But here we see the branchology and what I look for, which is the structure and the real dynamic part of the tree.
So you have, I think, 79 pieces here.
Yes.
When you are out and about, driving down the road or what have you, if you see a tree, do you pull over and start to?
Well, I'm always looking for trees, yes. And I love all sorts of trees, from young trees to ancient trees of myth and legend. And, you know, both in winter and in summer, you know, from the very young, elegant, windswept trees to ancient old trees.
And so, you have not only paintings, but you also have drawings as well.
I think what you see in this exhibit with the drawings is both chronological and multi-layered in the depth of the exhibit. So you see the working creative process from creating drawings right on through to the paintings.
Now, trees, you do a beautiful job with them, but that's not all you do. You also have some of your work here. There's not a just
that's right. Part of some of the definition of the exhibit is so that I would not be typecast just as an artist that does trees. So there's lots of architecture here, images of the Tennessee residents and of Cheekwood.
Yeah.
There's a whole room just of Cheekwood drawings
in
of
one
the architecture and rock formations and panoramic landscapes.
Yes, and I know also in one of the rooms is a work that you're working on that's very special to Cheekwood.
Yes, and that's the Swan Lawn Chinkapin Oak, which there's a series of five images that I've done, of which that work in process is one of those.
I love
where
that
I
tree.
Sit directly on site working from the tree.
I was curious about that. You actually sit in front of that tree.
That's right. Many hours.
Yes.
Most people don't realize just how demanding the time element is to create some of these images, and my fidelity to the subject and getting that structure just right.
Well, your work being here is a part of Cheekwood's celebration of trees. So from now through April, there's going to be all sorts of events. You're going to be leading a tour. You're going to be leading a workshop.
A workshop, yes.
And there's going to be lots of other things that are tied into just all the beauty that's in trees.
Yes, that's correct.
And we would encourage everyone to come out and see your work for themselves, because you will not believe it until you actually see it for yourself in person, because TV does not do it justice.
Well, you're being very nice.
No, you're a very talented man. And thank you so much for taking the time out to come speak with us.
Right.
For more information about this wonderful exhibition, just go to Cheekwood's website, which is cheekwood.org.